Hi there again, I'm here with you with another Twinmotion rendering. This time is the Twinmotion Friday exercise time. I think I'm a bit late to be mentioned by the Twinmotion team with my final render, but this project was so beautiful that of course I had to create my own rendering. And here, of course, as always, I have already used all the materials, just applied all the materials to all the surfaces. All these materials come from the Twinmotion library. I didn't want to use this water texture material. Let's maybe use a glass. And this time something like that, and with this material you can, for the pool, for the water, you can increase of course the scale, so you will see in the final render all the normals that should create the water effect. Maybe let me just increase it a little bit more. Yeah, something like that. And this is better than the water materials from the Twinmotion library, so you can use it. Maybe if you want, you can use a different color, but yeah, from my point of view, this one from default is okay. And all the 3D models have been already inserted from here. All these plants are from the Megascan library, all the rocks, these boxwood, let's say, are from the Megascan library as well as for the other models. Not the table and the chairs, because these are from I don't know what kind of website as the plants, but as someone of you already noticed, there are some plants, some beautiful trees, and some, I don't remember. Oh yeah, this plant from, not from the Twinmotion libraries, but from Max3 website. I already created a video on it, so just check it out. I'd like to take just 20 seconds, I promise, to inform you that I'm creating the Twinmotion Masterclass Learning Portal, where I will guide you through the fantastic world of Twinmotion. Whether you're a beginner or an expert. Click on the link in the description of this video to stay updated on all the news and secure an exclusive discount at launch. Register now using your email. Thank you so much for the support and enjoy the video. And also the terrain. As you can see, this terrain is not completely flat because of course I put some... I don't remember what kind of terrain is, but yeah, some mossy forest ground to recreate this effect, so not to be flat the ground, so you will have of course a better grass effect. Again, for this particular effect I created a specific video, so just check it out too. And before creating the environment, the ambience settings and lights and so on, and creating the landscape here, the scenario. But first of all, I need to create a media, and for this media, yeah, let's put our camera here. Let me just search for this water material. Also, I can use again this glass material, and again increase the scale 25. Yeah, so I will have a better result. And of course, back to my camera, just increase it a little bit, something like that. I want of course to see my Yakutsi, So maybe something like this. Okay. But for now, I'm just using the Lumen engine. The final render will be in PathTracer. But the Lumen engine for me is perfect because I don't want to see only these trees behind the scene, reflecting on the glass here and maybe this way, because I want to put maybe with the help of this new media preview. I'm using from my user library some ambience only to create the perfect scenario behind my scene, okay? And the only one thing I'm doing here is to take maybe this hill and put it on my scene. Oh no, I think it's in the orientation, but no problem. 90 degrees, taking it, moving there. As you can see from my glass reflection, now I can maybe move my heel in a way that here again I can see something different. Okay, maybe duplicate it so I have a little shape here, so and maybe another one here, another one here for this part of the rendering, and also duplicate it here. Another hill here, this point maybe. Okay, so just switch it on, and now I have my heels behind the trees, my ear reflecting here, and now, of course, I'm ready to my scene, and of course, with some ambience too. Well, of course, first of all, our format, but the format is perfectly at the moment. For the camera, I'm just modifying the vignetting up to 60%, sharpness 25, and maybe some chromatic aberration 3. These are my default values. You can see it in all my videos, so you should know when and how to put it. Well, these values for the PathTracer, not for now for the Lumen, whether I fog 0, location, don't care, and maybe for the HDRI environment, I'm creating something. In particular, I want to use something from the skies, of course. Something low about the sun, something clear, and maybe this one because the sun is higher than this one. I'm not downloading all the skies from here because I'm always using the same skies. Okay, let me just rotate it. Okay, this way. Yeah, something like that. Okay, perfect. And for now, the lumen is completely finished. I can, of course, switch to the PathTracer mode. And the PathTracer for me, medium, is okay. So I can perfectly see how the lights is performing. So right now, the environment 1 has a value. Let me just modify it to 2. Okay. So some details. Sun intensity is zero because I already have my sun, my sunlight, so it's okay this way. Maybe some reflection to its maximum. Some ambient 1.5, 2, I don't know. Yeah, maybe 2. Now, of course, the camera from the environment section, I have nothing more to do. The exterior renderings are easier than the interior renderings, and these values I already modified are the only ones that you should modify. Of course, if you are using an HDRI, if you are using the precise location, of course there are other tools you should use, but I think intensity, rotation, and ambient, and you're done with this exterior scene. After that, of course, the camera. From here, I want, of course, to modify my white balance because this scene is a low sun scene, so it should be a little bit, let's say, hotter, okay? So, of course, not this value, but maybe, I don't know, something like that, let's say. For the exposure, oh, well, one for the moment is okay. Shadow boost. At the moment, I don't want to have this kind of shadow boost because it's too bright. So maybe, let's say, in the middle. But the highlight reduction for me is at the top of this value. Just know that you can, as the majority of the tools in Twinmotion, go over this value. So if I write 1.5, I will increase my highlight reduction. Okay? So maybe at the moment I can put 1.25. And this is okay. And I'm finished. Nothing more to do. For the effects in the contrast, I'm creating something lower with a lower value. Of course, understand that the if you have a lower is a low value for the contrast, your scene would be brighter, of course. If you have a higher contrast value, your scene is darker. But I think this is okay. And for the saturation, I don't want the grass to be this green, so maybe, yeah, something like that for the moment. And that's it, my rendering is done. Of course, now I'm, of course, create the first attempt. Yeah, medium value is perfect. Quit media mode, export, plus, I'm rendering this image here. I'm not cutting the video because it will be finished in a couple of seconds. As I was saying before, the most important thing here in an exterior scene is the scene itself, so all the mat no, not the materials, but all the textures you're using, all the objects, all the 3D models you're using, and in this scene in particular, the vegetation. This vegetation has been, of course, I don't remember if this is for free or if I purchased it, but of course, if you have this kind of tree, this kind of agave, and so on, of course your render would be better. But don't waste time. Let me just pick the render. And this is the medium quality render I just created. As you can see, there is a big difference between the Twinmotion 3 and a purchased 3, and here is the same. But from my point of view, this jacuzzi water is perfect. This pool water is perfect. The grass on the ground is perfect. Yeah, maybe for the ambience, I could decrease a little bit more the contrast, but other things I can't see to be modified. As you can see here, I have, of course, my heels, and here too. Yeah, I think it's perfect. The only one thing, of course, to be modified here is the contrast, so decreasing it a little bit. Yeah, maybe something like that. And for the saturation, let me check the saturation. Oh, it's perfect. So, perfect. So, maybe changing the tracer values, of course. For the final render, I'm not using low, medium, or higher. I'm using, for the samples, 10, 20, or max bounces at least 15. But of course, you can increase this value. I can, of course, use 50 as max bounces, but I think in this scene, 15 would be enough. Yeah, maybe you can turn off the denoiser so your scene will be perfectly calculated, but I think this scene is really simple that the denoiser is not playing a crucial role for the fireflies. You can decrease it, but as the denoiser, this scene is really easy to render. So, of course, image 4K. Of course, I'm rendering this scene and put the final render at the end of this video. And again, thank you for watching this really short tutorial about the last Friday exercise for the Twinmotion, from the Twinmotion team. Subscribe to help me, and of course, put a like to help me again with the algorithm, and suggest me other topics to be rendered in the next video. Thank you for watching, and see you in the next video. Ciao!